Yes, Laura Dern. Darling, hello.
I'm so thrilled to meet you,
finally. I'm so thrilled to meet you. Going through your credits as I waited to come to talk to you, it's impossible. You've done everything with everybody.
I have, Stephen.
And I'm known as the Oscar messenger, so I'm here to tell you that one of these days, Laura, you two will get an Oscar. You've been nominated twice.
Oh, that's very sweet.
And this film, what a part. I didn't expect to see you in this part. Oh, my God.
It's so crazy.
I had the time of my life. Really? Okay.
Oh, my God. I mean, working with Woody is extraordinary, as you can imagine. He's just amazing. But for us to do a comedy together that is so broken and painful and yet hilarious.
Tell our viewers about this character.
Wilson, Woody's character, goes on this journey to find his estranged wife from 17 years ago who's fallen on bad times with addiction and some street work. We'll just call it that. And here she is. And we go on a very kind of memorable and profound journey of this search for our daughter that was given up for adoption. So
bizarre to the max. I mean, it was just indescribable. I mean, the movie is indescribable because he's such a unique, strange character.
Oh, my God.
And so is she.
Yeah. And they, and you know, I think the part that is so deeply, sadly relatable is this idea that maybe we're lucky enough to find a love of our life and we don't get to be with them. And that's, I think that resonates for a lot of people.
Yes, it did.
So,
but
I find that all really beautiful.
Was there any particular part of this that you just loved more than others? That
I mean, beating up Cheryl Hines is really fun.
Oh. Yeah, I just forgot her name. I just interviewed her.
Oh my God.
I couldn't remember her last name.
She is amazing. But, you know, I think just being at play with Woody is incredible. And kind of recreating their love story for us was amazing.
It's a unique character for him and a unique character for you. I mean, for him to, I mean, he seems to be suffering from many different mental ailments.
Yeah. And, you know, the thing that I love that to me is a very politically subversive comment within this movie is you watch a film where everybody's thinking about how impossible a person who gets in your face and in your space and wants you to get off a device and look in his eyes and actually connect and might say something even hurtful because it's the truth for him is so abhorrent. But our culture is comfortable with con men. And that scares me more than anything. That
sounds
we would,
like you're describing a talk show host, but
or a president. I mean,
or it, both.
Yeah,
yes,
it's an interesting consideration. Like, why is the truth so uncomfortable? Because I'd rather a Wilson any day.
Yes,
who tells me who he sees, who loves me for all my mess and all my complication, because there's a deep loyalty and fierceness of loyalty in him too. Versus the person who tells you what you want to hear.
Now, then, I also have to say I loved you in Certain Women.
Oh, thank you.
Loved that film.
I do too.
And you're one of the greatest actresses of your generation, and I'm so honored to meet you at last.
Oh, me too, Stephen. What a privilge to talk to you.
And I always say at the end of every show, have a fabulous.
Have a fabulous you. Thank you so much. I'm so excited finally.